I work in a school.
Yes.
So every time, whenever there is time to pray, the thing is, the staff room is usually, everyone's wearing slip shoes, men, women, walking around. So for me, I feel very uncomfortable to just put the janamas. I don't mind praying in public, alhamdulillah. But, you know, if I have to pray inside a room, it's so difficult. Is it okay to pray inside a staff room?
So let me take this question, because that's a very practical daily issue. So, alhamdulillah, she has no problem praying in public, but she doesn't feel comfortable praying in the break room. This is how I'm going to straight answer. This is how shaitan comes to us. There's a beautiful book called Ighathatul Lahfa min Masa'id al-Shaytan. It's an Imam Ibn al-Qayyim, 2-volume. How shaitan has his tricks for every individual. So the sister, may Allah bless her, she has no problem praying in public. So the shaitan says, I'm not going to come and tell her everybody is looking at you, because it's not going to work. But it works on other people. So what is the trick? The place is not clean. What is the answer? It's from Rasul alayhi salatu wasalam. وَجُعِلَتْ لِيَ الْأَرْضُ طَهُورًا. Rasul alayhi salatu wasalam said, the earth was made for me as pure. The only place we cannot pray fiqhan is in the bathroom, or if there is a najasa. Even if there is a najasa, you know the famous hadith of the Bedouin who came to the masjid, please forgive me, and urinated. Absolutely, you pray, you put your jainamas, you don't want your prayer, anything, but don't you ever compromise your salah, because that's one of the ways. I hear it a lot from sisters, I can do wudu in the bathroom. That's the other thing. I don't have my hijab. I don't have my socks. All these, I keep telling them, this is how shaitan comes to you. I don't know about the... I had actually a long discussion one time with a brother. He said, I just feel very uncomfortable doing wudu in public. I was like, why? Why? Learn how to do the wudu of Rasul alayhi salatu wasalam with one cup. You don't have to do a flood zone as we always see it, unfortunately. Unfortunately, right? In our masajid. Learn, he used to do one cup. Do only the arkan. Don't do the sunnah. If it means that I'm going to do the arkan, but I'm going to keep my salah, do it. Absolutely. I'll tell you one thing. You know, when you have children, you raise children, I'm sure all of you, you have these things in home. You said this is non-negotiable, right? There's red lines. You all have it. This is what you say to yourself. I'm going to share this with you, everybody, just to give you an idea. And I'm not praising myself, a'udhu billah. I just left my private practice 2 weeks ago, because we're going to be teaching full-time, as some of you know. So the staff made a, you know, farewell party. Okay, alhamdulillah, Rabbil Alameen. I'm the only Muslim in the practice. And we have totally about 25. I'm talking about Midwest. I'm not talking about California. Everybody is either white or white or black, and nobody is a Muslim. They've never seen a Muslim. I got 2 gifts. I couldn't believe it. I mean, alhamdulillah, Rabbil Alameen, alhamdulillah, I got a lot of gifts. One gift, I actually took a picture and shared with everybody. This is where I want to put on every social media, because that's what you want to show people. And this is from a nurse who is worked with me probably 2 or 3 months, and most of my patients are also Muslim. It's basically something you put on your desk. It's like a glass, and she put in it, she made it herself, in it, like a wire that has lights. So far, so good. What's written on that glass? In Arabic, Alhamdulillah. When I opened it up, and I was like, what made you think of it? And she said, because I hear it from you and from your patients. I said, where did you find it? Dr. Yunus, Google. That's how she said it. Wallahi. And the second gift I got, I couldn't believe this one. And this is actually the sajada I carry with me. And this is from the manager. Sajada, bead, blue, and like a book marker that has Islamic. You know what, when people ask me about Islamophobia, you know my answer? We have Islamophobia. It's not them. We are scared. We are scared to say we are Muslims. Why? Why? What is the big deal? What is the big deal? As I always remember this, the statement of Sayyidina Umar, أَلَسْنَا عَلَىٰ حَقِّ. He used to tell Rasul alayhi salatu wasalam, aren't we on the truth? I'm not going to be bragging about Islam in front of non-Muslim. I'm saying this to myself. Why am I shy to say I'm a Muslim? Why you wear your hijab? Because that's how Allah told me. Why do you dress like this? This is my Islamic identity. What is the big deal? Why all the people who are not on the truth disobey Allah everywhere you find them? And they're not shy to say it. Why we are? And that's part of, the more you do this, the more you are connected.